come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line. Now Wilson. He'll get that complete to Albert O. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Bronco first down.
But when you hit him on the move like that, he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam. Oh, boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. Here's a handoff out of the gun. And give him about 5 as he gets this up to the 48-yard line.
Oh, that was a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky that play only picked up 5 yards.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. They snap it at 1. Now Wilson. A quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time. Separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass. Throwing is Wilson. Man open, he's got it complete to Cortland Sutton. And he will go out right near the 35-yard line. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on 3rd down.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. 1st down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
On 1st down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he maneuvers up the middle for 3, and it's 2nd down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
2nd and 7 with our score tied at 7, but they're planning to change that soon. Only question, will they get 3 or 6 out of it? And they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 7 yards there and a 1st down.
But they're getting ready to go to work now in prime real estate after that last run. Found his spot and picked up nice yardage, didn't he?
And now he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. On 1st down. Open man. He completes it to Judy. And they're going to get this down inside the 20.
It's a pickup of 6. Brings up 2nd and 4 at the 19-yard line.
looking to throw again on second down. Wilson. And they're going to be set up now with the ball at the 13-yard line.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then of course they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play. And that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
Now Wilson on first down. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
They're putting together a drive here in the final minutes of the half, but the coverage has been tight all game long, and they certainly want to keep them off the scoreboard here.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he's going to get about four down inside the 10 to the 9.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Out of the gun, and he will fight his way into the end zone for a Bronco touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown run, and the Broncos have moved out in front. McManus's point after is good, and that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. So remember, Charles, last time they were out here, they scored, but they just saw the opposition score, and they're trailing right now, so they're trying to keep pace here. They need a touchdown drive.
Well, if you're a fan of offense, you're loving this, but if you're a fan of defense, this is tough to watch, and it's also tough to keep that up when you just watch your opponent march down the field on a scoring drive that lasts into double-digit snaps. You need a score here, not just to follow the momentum from your last drive, but put the onus back on your opponent. And that's what they're doing right now, swapping that onus back and forth.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. It's a loss of 4 on the first down play.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
So a step in the wrong direction. Now they'll look to make amends on second and 14. Here's Mayfield. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
And An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Mayfield. He's got a man. That's Marshall. And this is going to be another first down as they'll make the tackle at the Broncos 23. Mayfield to throw it. And this one almost intercepted. Had a chance to come down with it in the end zone, but could not hang on.
So it looks like they stopped some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. And that is incomplete.
That play call wasn't there for them against that coverage. So they're going to spin the dial now in their playbook and come up with one more shot at the marker to try and keep this series going.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Throwing, Mayfield. This is caught. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. A chance now to get even before the break as they come. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Christian McCaffrey with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Panthers are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half. Gonzalez good on the extra point, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. And they'll have a little bit of time to work with. 35 seconds until the break. On first down, Wilson. That's complete. It's Okwuegbunam. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
From the 30 on second down, Wilson. And he will find his big tight end over the middle. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. It used to be occasional, right, safety valve. Throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Field goal unit not out there. They want six before halftime.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, ah, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Panthers going to get the football first, trailing here as well as we resume play in this second half. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Well, Charles, in that first half, we saw a fair amount of offense on both sides of the football, and now the team trailing here will start with it in the third quarter.
And we both know this coach pretty darn well, don't we? Because his game planning is always on point. And now that he's getting the ball to start the second half, how about all the offensive jammer he referenced in the first half? He'll put that all together and come out with something really strong, I believe, to get things going here in the third quarter.
That's a nickel set here defensively on third and inches.
Still want to be prepared for a pass.
They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the first. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
On first down, they look downfield, and it's complete. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A big pickup of 38.
When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
McCaffrey running up the middle. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. The last run got nine. That leaves him with second and a yard. They're going for Lazard, but this is intercepted. And the Broncos are going to take over here on the INT at their own 5-yard line. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone, possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
They'll start on the ground here on first down. And he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. It shows you right there, he can do more than just cover in the secondary from that free safety position.
Yeah, the evolution of the position has really been significant, hasn't it? Because a lot of teams no longer have a free safety, strong safety designation. They just have safeties. So wherever the ball is, one can be close to the line of scrimmage.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. He's at the 30. 10, 5, and all the way home for a Broncos score. And that run massively increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
And break out your calculator, partner, because his yards per carry went up significantly, right? Big-time jaunt all the way to the end zone.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time, don't we? The defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum. So you know they're riding high right now, and they're ready to challenge this offense and that quarterback one more time.
And we'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in this second half. Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Now the Broncos are going to take a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Here's second and seven now from the 28. And for Mayfield, this could be a free play. And this one drops incomplete, but I think the defense jumped. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly. Ping, ping,
ping. Second down and right back to McCaffrey. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. From the gun, Mayfield. Throw right side. The ball comes out, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. Offensively, they're just not playing a very clean football game right now. This deficit, there's a fumble. Good news for them, at least, that went out of bounds.
You're exactly right, and as they breathe a sigh of relief, you know they're looking at the scoreboard, thinking to themselves, if we turn it over there, things could really get rough for us trying to make a comeback in this game.
The fumble on first down now. Here's second down. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off by Pat Surtain. And the Broncos are going to have the short field here as they'll take over right at the 50. Second straight drive now here, Charles, and have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one, or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
So first and 10 here for Wilson and the Broncos, right at the 50-yard line. After the interception, here's Wilson. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line. And they had just picked it off to get the football. They fumble it right back. I looked over to both sidelines. A lot of scrambling to find the helmets.
Yeah, you can almost, I mean, you know both sides are screaming sudden change. Because when sudden change happens, that's a defensive call to get back out on the field. There's been a fumble, so an interception type of a turnover. You've got to get back out there and play. These guys just want to get to the bench and gather themselves and regroup a little bit. Let's see if these offenses can settle in and start taking care of the ball a little bit better.
2 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Second and 8. Field now from the 50. The ball's out. McCaffrey lost it. It's picked up by the Broncos. He has been a workhorse for them in this game, and ball security hasn't been an issue until that point.
Yeah, and let's face it, when he's going to carry the ball that many times, he becomes more and more of a target for the defense, knowing that he's going to be the primary guy. They'll just send more and more players towards him, trying to make sure they knock the ball free.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. He continues to have a big night here under the lights carrying the football.
And some guys prefer night games. For whatever reason, their bodies react a certain way. They love the spotlight. Maybe that's what it is. The best seats in the house, the ones where he's carrying the football for his offensive teammates. The worst seats, the 11 guys trying to tackle him on defense.
14. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Big Derek Brown making the stop.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he only manages a couple here down to about the 38-yard line.
He's definitely tough to get down. We just saw it right there. But how about what we did see? Pursuit, wrap up, and then the big finish with the tackle.
They'll need to get it to the 30 for a first. This is third down. Wilson. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
And they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. Flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit. The delay of game backs him up 5, first and 15.
Zach Bibby.
From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Throwing on second down, Wilson. This will be caught, Judy. Touchdown, Broncos. Jerry Judy, 30 yards. And the Broncos are looking to make it 2 straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead. Extra point from McManus is good. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat.
Looking left side, that's caught by Moore.
They'll come up now second and four from the 31. Mayfield now, eluding the pressure right. Oh, he just needed to throw it away, but instead, out of bounds he goes, and that's a sack. They'll wind up losing a full 10 yards on the play, and that'll force upon him a third and 14. Need a crafty play call here. 14 yards is what they need to try to convert this thing. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. They'll get this to McCaffrey out of the backfield. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. Able to convert on third and 14. A terrific play call.
Those are the types of plays they probably wish they had made more of in the first three quarters. And this deficit going to be tough to overcome here in the fourth. But a nice first down and a pickup on that throw.
Yeah, and this is where as coaches, you're looking for effort and execution even though the scoreboard is going against you. You want to find out who's going to fight, who's going to scrap, who's going to keep their heads up and continue to play.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Now Mayfield. This will be caught downfield by Marshall. Touchdown!
I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play, and that was something special there. Boy, was he moving.
And that's the kind of play where you have to kind of catch your breath afterwards. So just give me a second here, because when he shifted into high gear, he was an absolute blur out there. No substitute for speed. We talk about that all the time. The evidence was right there.
And if you're wondering how fast he was going, next-gen stats clocked him at close to 21 miles an hour.
So the lead back down to 10 as things get a little more interesting, and the kick is away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. Well, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Here's a handoff out of the gun. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 161 yards rushing for him now as his fine rookie season continues.
And carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out. Hey, zero, zero, zero.
I think this is a free play for Wilson. He'll let this go deep for Sutton, and that'll be incomplete. The flag was down, so they took a shot, thinking it's on the defense. Let's see.
A penalty accepted, and they move the ball forward.
Got it. they'll try to take advantage of that offsides call. Here's first and five. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line. And a nice milestone reached on that last throw as here late in the season, he goes over 4,000 yards passing.
And he's really thrown the ball well all season long, had some big games along the way. He's inspired his receiving corps to go out and make plays for him in each and every ball game.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And for one of the first times all night, he is going to go nowhere as they bury him behind the line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. Shot here on the ground, and he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. Third and 15 coming up after that loss of two. Tall task ahead of him here, needing a full 15 yards to move the chains.
Hey, Kiro, Kiro, Kiro. 14.
Third and long, it's Wilson. Oh, and this will be incomplete. The rush gets home just as he was letting that go. That could have been worse. Instead, it's fourth down. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. Back now on EA Sports as the kick teams are out here following the two-minute warning. After splitting the uprights, McManus to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
On second down, McCaffrey. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. They're coming to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Here's Baker. He'll get this out right here to McCaffrey. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Well, that's one way to convert on third down, picking up 26 yards. Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
Mayfield. And this is going to fall to the ground, incomplete. That very nearly their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
Limited time left on the clock after that incompletion, so I think both sides are going to savor every second to prepare before the next snap. Because once the ball's in motion, it may be a nonstop push to finish this drive off. Everyone better be on the same page right now, because I think they're going to try and get several plays off in quick succession if they can.
Mayfield to throw. And this is intercepted, and that should do it.
Well, it wasn't always pretty, but the interception there, that means that they should get out of here with a victory.
Yeah, this is not a game that they're going to preserve for posterity on defense, but they did finish it off, didn't they? They did make the winning play to close things out. They'll take that one and head to the locker room.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. Oh, Wilson gonna throw. Open man, he completes it to Judy. Past the 20! And all the way home for a Broncos score! Jerry Judy, his second touchdown of the night. And the Broncos have put this one to bed here in the fourth quarter. But not much defensive resistance on that drive. And really, Charles, the way this offense has been humming, they haven't faced much defensive resistance the entire game.
Yeah, I think it's safe to say that one team, their defense did not wake up and make it to the stadium for this one. There may be some major changes on that side of the ball when we see them the next time out.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
Following the sack, Mayfield and the Panthers staring at a third and long here. To throw, and he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know, what do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you, no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
One last shot for Mayfield here. And he's not able to get away. He is stopped well short of a first down.
Well, partner, under the lights in primetime, this offense, they gave the nation quite a show putting up that many.
When the rush comes, the word I gotta do, I'm moving with it too. Yeah, I paid it. Yeah, oh, tell me what I gotta do. Pull up in a bucket crew, one for me and one for you. Yeah, like with the rules. I'm off the chain, don't cut me loose. Yeah, I'm off the chain, I'm off the noose. Yeah, get them picked off Bentley white like cotton. Residential so good, my joints don't got a lot. Watch the dirty money with Oxy. I miscount cause I'm off a... Yeah, this bigger than a damn proxy. Call my... He said copy. Get that pluck like a boogie. I like riches, hit like nookies. You ain't scared of no... But you scared to put on your hoodie. Man, my... like Woody.
I just scraped it off the top. Cut it on the road, out the curb, out the block. I was already sold, out of work by 10 o'clock. Too deep in the streets, felt that pain, but it meant a lot. Whenever she calls, know what I gotta do. I'm moving with a two, I paid it out in full. Oh, yeah.
New toys.
Convoy.
100 carats on my neck, my boy. That 100 bunny rabbits trying to get
my boy.
From the cabbage I collect, my boy. Heard you this gorillas, let me check,
my boy.
Say nothing silly, you regret, my boy. Cause we got banana on the
my boy.
And I can send it in a text, my boy. Thumbs up or the emoji with the flex,
my boy.
Personalize every threat, my boy. Toll free. That's direct, my boy. And if you need a couple, I'm the connect, my boy. Off the top.
I just scraped it off the top. Cut it off the road. Out the curve, out the block. I was already sold, out of work by 10 o'clock. Too deep in the streets, felt that pain, but it meant a lot.
God for me, who could be against me? I guess all the that's against me, they the ones stirring up the conflict. They try to make it out like I'm conflicted. East Coast, the 6-4's hitting switch. It's not a conflict of interest.
Cut it with the business. West Coast rocking them Timberlands, deep up in them trenches. It's no difference. Neither one play games when swinging for them fences. We want the finer things, that's expensive. They hit them either close range or at a distance. If God for me, why bother? I got my game from the Godfather. Top of the food chain, rock bottom, and handle my business when it was my problem. Jeep, flossing with a gold chain. I got my Turkish rope with matching gold things. Bomber jacket in the winter, it's a cold game. I met some East Coast up in Spokane. Some of the realest in this dope game. I got my curly top looking like Special Ed. Clean fade on the side, bumping that red head. Clean tags when I ride, ducking the fed feds. East Coast, they get that bread, bread. You put the, you end up dead, dead. Them West Coast, they leave that spread. And now you got all in your dread head.
If God for me, who could be against me? I guess all the that's against me, they the ones stirring up the conflict. They try to make it out like I'm conflicted.
Still trying to the riches.
East Coast, the 6-4's hitting switch. It's not a conflict of interest.
Cut it with the business. West Coast rocking them Timberlands, deep up in them trenches. It's no difference. Fourth and inches. I'm finna hit a lick and handle business. I got her down. She real vicious. Rock a bye, baby. No witness. This is not even a conflict. You no nonsense. Got the same way in Brooklyn and Compton. But with that gang gang, to make a profit. On top, stay poppin'. Look. See, I was the high school slick Rick, I was styling. Fat gold chain with an African medallion. Hip hop connoisseur and rolling 20 gripping. Rap game real tight, freestyle was magnificent. All about the clout and all about my dividends. Them older couldn't tell me different. I need a roundaway girl to let me. Showtime, Mythique Apollo. I'm about the bottom. Take two and pull out a little for my. Who won't live to see tomorrow?
If God for me, who could be against me? I guess all the that's against me, they the ones stirring up the conflict. They try to make it out like I'm conflicted.
Yeah.
Turn me up.
Yeah. Hey, check it. Okay, I feel unstoppable. Losing's impossible. Go against the team, the thing they know not to do. Bright lights, game on the line, do what I gotta do. Time after time, we do the impossible. You ain't made it till you got stylists go out and shop for you. You ain't made it till they pour on top of you. Parading through the city, the whole block come out for you. We just getting started, y'all finna see what we bout to do. Boy, stop. You ain't here? I'm the real truth. Hunters real blue, strips on them still new. Shopping at Dover Street, I'm dripping like mildew. They say you don't visit the hood, dog, I still do. A real one, only difference, my bill's bigger. I'm still with ya, I just got rich a little quicker. The same man, God handed me his game plan. I ain't perfect, far from it, what can I say, man? I feel unstoppable, losing's impossible. Go against the team, the thing they know not to do. Bright lights, game on the line, do what I gotta do. Time after time, we do the impossible. It felt like yesterday, I was just driving my grandma's Chevrolet. From South Carolina to Maryland, I take the jet today. I'm still on the come up, I'm still building my resume. I still got a lot to prove, but still I'm heavyweight. I still gotta watch my moves. They tried to defamate my character, but I won't let them. It's always checkmate. I'm still screaming, the world hope she. Mother Nature's my first shorty, watch how I go ballistic and I'm so terrific. Accounts is copacetic, I don't need no permission, but I'm so indebted to this game that I love, and most of all to the man above. Now check me out, now it's just that Fridays was serving the greens. Before I was popping, I was nursing my dreams. Now I ain't never been a gangster, but I know a few things. I just rather get the bag and start collecting the rings. But I done spoke too much, close curtain and scene. I am not a human being, I'm a full machine. I ain't holier than thou, I don't judge, I seen. Just staying down for the come up till I reign supreme. Let's get it. Yeah, hit boy, we got another one. Ha! Man, y'all boys ain't ready for this, man. I'm still grinding, I'm still hungry.
against the team, the thing they know not to do. Bright lights, game on the line, do what I gotta do. Time after time, we do the impossible.
Yeah.
Hold up, it ain't easy breaking away or being a great. They slamming the door, I'm jumping the gate. Cause a starving stomach like being punched in the face. And an instrumental with the last time that I ate. Full from all of the base. My ace boom goon, big son told me about the game. 20 years later, know my name. King crown me lounge in the back of the spot. Pay homage to an underground peasant, climb to the top. Funny style. On elevators could never fade us. I peep data stain anytime they congratulate us. Goggles is worn and bottles is popping. I'm beyond Sanders, don't hate us. This ice bucket dropping over their head with it. They shoot a crib with it. You either fight or flight, I ain't one for the ledge living. I do it for the one that died but fed millions. With soul food flowed and stock my bare kitchen. I'm liberated. I drew a play that they ain't illustrated. I make a move they gladly imitated. I ain't flattered, I'm a dragon to your paper castle. The Alpha and Omega, promise it ain't nothing after a new beginning. My catalog like James Earl Jones, the ever living. Imagine if I did make beats, that's more for killing. Imagine if you come from the side by my city. You probably wouldn't make it, oh yeah, yeah, really.
I go extra to be great. I go extra for the fam, I go extra for the cake. I got extras on the plate. I go extra every day, I got extras on the way.
How much?
Extra, extra.
How much?
Extra, extra.
How much?
Extra, extra.
How much?
Extra, extra.
Ain't no mileage of foreign dollars. Configure the road I travel. Don't gravel that probably baffle it. Label scribble on paper, they wanna shackle it. I own my masters and royalties, you can't raffle it. Wrist drip like a mango, fingertips like I'm Thanos. Knocking those down, no bangles. Without a Kango, tailor made. Walk with a limp, them bands is heavy, I need a brace. I am money, I guess the world is just a safe combination needed, not a coca key. I'm the extra lighter on the dresser. I know you need it, smoking out the competition. Pouring up, we undefeated. What you heard, listen, heard, we eating. Talking by extra with a splash, extra acting bad. Pull up like parades on parades, extra with a slab. Pay what it call for the tail, extra with the band. Young Cruiser King, better add extra on the.
I go extra to be great. I go extra for the fam, I go extra for the cake. I got extras on the plate. I go extra every day, I got extras on the way.
How much?
Extra, extra.
How much?
Extra, extra.
How much?
Extra, extra.
How much?
Extra, extra.
Hello boys and girls, I got some true stories to tell. You're back outside, but they still lied. Whoa, yeah.
Take off the fufu, take off the cloud chase, take off the Wi-Fi. Take off the money phone, take off the car loan, take off the flex and the white loss. Take off the weird jewelry, I'ma take 10 steps, then I'm taking off top off. Take off them fabric cage dreams and the microwave memes, it's a real world outside. Take off your idols, take off the runway, take off the Cairo. Take off the Sandro, pay 5 days stay, take a quarter meal, hella fine. Take off the far flat, take off reception, take off the cop with the iPad. Take off the allure, take off the unsure, take off decisions I lack. Take off the fake deep, take off the fake woke, take off the I'm broke, I care. Take off the gossip, take off the new logic, that if I'm rich, I'm real. Take off the should nail, take off the doje, take off the broken bag. Take all that designer off and what do you have?
You ugly.
You out of pocket.
Two ATMs, you stepping to what?
You out of pocket.
Who you think they talk about? Talk about us.
You out of pocket.
Who you think they carry off us?
Get back in pocket.
The world in a panic, the women is stranded, the men on the run. The profits are vanished, the law take advantage. The market is crashing, the industry wants to sleep in the box while they making a mockery following us. This ain't monopoly, watch it for love. This ain't monogamy, y'all getting fucking. Jumping on what the hell is that? I gotta relax when I feel. All my descendants, they come in my sleep and say I am too real. I'm done with the sensitive, taking it personal. Done with the black and the white, the wrong and the right. You hoping for change in curricles, I know the feelings that came with burials cries.